So hey guys, welcome back to a new video, and as you guys know, I have been using Android smartphone for a long time now. And yeah, this video is my perspective, or an Android fanboy perspective, of the latest Android 12 that is currently under development. I have been using it for a few days now, and yeah, I think I'm ready to review it. As you guys know, there are tons of videos out there talking about the same, but what makes this video different is that we are testing the Android 12 not on the Pixel devices. Instead, as you might know, I'm testing it on my Mi 90 or Redmi K20. Thanks to a few friends who have made this possible. If you would love to check this out, or if you want to install the same, head over to the Telegram group and I'll mention the Telegram handle of every single person who helped me through this process. Feel free to check the description. So hey guys, once again, my name is Neville. I bring tech and related content in quality to you. So if you are not subscribed, please subscribe. You're watching this on Neville Studios, and without no further ado, let's move on to the video. As I said, the main aspect is we are not using a Pixel device, so we get to know for sure how the Android 12 might work on other different smartphone brands out there. For example, mine is a Mi Redmi smartphone, and to be honest, sacrificing a few things, it works perfectly close to a nice build. Yes, it is a beta build made for the Pixel devices, and bugs are mandatory. Let's look on what I think on Android 12. To be honest, I'm not a huge fan of heavily rounded corners and circles, but Android 12 surprised me with the same. It kinda looks different compared to the previous Android versions, but yeah, who doesn't like a new UI style change? Something that I have to say a bit harsh is about the quick settings panel. And I know a lot of you guys agree with me how terrible it looks. I would love to know what you guys think, so feel free to comment down. The tiles are much more bigger and rectangular, and it has a lot of free space in it. There are text in it which I'm not able to digest. We have been used to minimal icons in the previous version, and I think it's more cool compared to this revamped design. The font looks amazing, which makes it appealing, but the brightness slider nearly killed me. First of all, it's really big, more than big, and it has a weird shape which makes me clearly know why I hate it. But it is easy to use, and it has more triggering space compared to the old ones. Volume slider is completely revamped too. It is big, but I don't hate it as much as I hate the brightness slider. It is easy to use, and the sleek animations are so satisfying. What I think Google is trying to achieve is to make their device more user-friendly, irrespective of the audience using it. The first feel I got is some accessibility settings where a bigger display size has been turned on for the whole UI. As you can see, the volume slider is thick as my finger. The display and default size is a bit more bigger when compared to A11. The lock screen is love. The new alignment style clock and the transition from AOD to lock screen is so soothing. You can also find a small pill at the top to indicate you to pull down the quick settings, which is something we don't know. And moving on, next we have Monit, and this is a new cool feature and my favorite one, which allows A12 to pick colors matching from your wallpaper and which will automatically change the system UI accent color. How incredible is that? A fresh look with every new wallpaper. We have a totally cool widget section when compared to the previous version. It is a list with expandable options. You can also swipe down to close the section, and as usual, press and hold to place a widget onto your home screen. The settings is completely redesigned too, and it's a thumbs up from my side. I really loved it. It really looks so close to the Samsung's One UI. And yeah, A12 looks so close to One UI. Every minute detail is much more noticeable, and the new look is fresh and eye-catching. The recent apps as for now is kinda similar, but with more rounded corners. Talking about the notifications, I really loved how it is presented. It's more round and bubbly, and it kinda looks cute. As I said, this is A12 beta build running on a Redmi smartphone. And surprisingly, for the first beta build, it's really smooth, and when it comes to the performance side, it's really stable. The animations, I really have to talk a lot about this. It is so fluid, and something I have never experienced before in any Android versions or custom ROMs like MIUI, OxygenOS, you name it. The overall feel is so smooth due to these animations. It's like your hand is being pulled in and out of a rubber band in each swipe, scroll and tabs. Switching between apps, notification center, expanding notification, recent apps, unlocking the phone, and even scrolling in third-party apps have this animation inbuilt into the core. You can see this rubber band pull, as I love to call it, everywhere, and it's kinda make this overall experience much more smoother and enjoyable. Talking about the core performance, I tried games, multitasking and all the heavy work I usually do on my device, and it's amazingly stable for a beta build. There are tons of videos out there which explains every minute new features, and if you're interested, you can watch the Google I/O program if you would love to see how Google introduced the same. But here I'm going to talk about the very few features which caught hold of me and which I think is incredible. Starting off with the one hand mode. This thing was something that I missed a lot. Even though it was missing in the previous stock Android version, it was present on other custom ROMs, but with the introduction of navigation gestures, it slowly died off. Android smartphones are getting bigger and larger these days, and this is something that is going to be a game changer. Just pull down on the navigation pillar bar to trigger the same. You can touch everything on top while still holding your phone with a single hand. The triggering is so smooth and fluid, which makes it a really good experience. Yeah, it's an iOS copy, but still it's working. You can also pull down the notification bar using a swipe down gesture on the navigation pillar. But yeah, there's a catch, either this or the one hand mode. A dark room plus an Android smartphone was a disaster to the eyes. Even if you reduced the brightness to the very minimum and turned on the nightlight, it was more than necessarily bright. Introducing extra dim, which tweaks the phone's display to make it much more dim. You have an intensity slider to play around to adjust it to your liking. You can also set a shortcut which can be triggered by pressing and holding your volume button simultaneously. You have a dedicated section for vibration and haptics, wherein which you can control the strength of vibration throughout your device. Tap assistance section allow you to configure touch and hold delay, time to take actions and an auto-click feature if you're using a connected mouse. You have a back tap feature inbuilt which is currently broken but may be fixed in a recent update. There are other minute features like charging animation dedicated with Monit and a Gboard which integrates with Monit, and much more features, but I don't think it's worth mentioning. I have been using it for quite a while now and I'm very satisfied with the battery performance. Even with the new animations and tweaking, there is no compromise in battery life. However, I felt a slight lag after heavy usage and while using the screen recording option, which is pretty normal for a beta build. So in overall, I loved Android 12, and it's after a few years Android is getting some noticeable cool features and revamp in design, which is always a plus side. As you guys did see, I was using my Redmi K20 or Mi 90 and it was working really good, and that is a good sign. I would really love to see how it develops throughout the future stages. I would love if you guys comment down your thoughts regarding the same and your favorite feature on the list. That's it guys for this video, hope you liked it. If so, please share this video with your friends and family. Also, thanks for watching. Please do like this video and also subscribe if you're new here. Also click the bell button to get to us every single time we upload a video. Comment down your suggestions, we're always here and replying you. This channel is fully based on your support, so please do show your love to the maximum. I put my heart and soul in making these videos, so please do support us. This is me, Neville. You're watching this on Neville Studios. Let you have an amazing time ahead. Signing out. Peace.